everyone. Today we'll discuss the part 37th of the important notes for biochemistry so that you can easily able to answer the one-liners and the MCQs in your exam. Proteins and the DNAs are bound by weak bonds such as the hydrogen bond, ionic bond, van der Waals force, and they never bond by the covalent bonds, and so because covalent bonds are very strong bonds, okay, but the proteins and the DNA are actually bonded by weak bonds. The bonds present in the DNA are the hydrogen bonds, 3', 5' phosphodiester bonds, and the beta and glycosidic bonds. 3', 5' phosphodiester bonds are formed between the 3' hydroxyl group of the previous nucleotide with 5' phosphate group of the incoming nucleotide. Okay, so this bond formed between the 3' hydroxyl group of the previous nucleotide and the 5' phosphate group of the incoming nucleotide. At the 5' end of a nucleic acid, there is always a free phosphate group present. At 3' end of a nucleic acid, a free hydroxy group is always present. New nucleotide is always added at the 3' end of a nucleic acid. Synthesis always occurs in the 5' to 3' direction. Reading and writing of the base sequence is always done in the 5' to 3' direction. Nucleases are enzymes which break the phosphodiester bond present between the sugar and the phosphate in a nucleic acid. Nucleases are of two types, that is the exonuclease and the endonuclease, or we can say exinuclease. Exonuclease cut the nucleic acid from the sides either from the 5' end or the 3' end. 5' to 3' exonuclease starts cutting from the 5' end and moves from 5' to 3' direction, of course. Restriction endonuclease cut the nucleic acid at specific site known as the palindromic sites. The fragments formed after digestion by restriction endonuclease enzyme are known as the restriction fragments. Palindromes are same sequence present on the opposite strand of the DNA reading in the 5' to 3' direction. Means over here, what is palindromic sequence? As you can see over here, whenever you will read from 5' to 3' direction, this sequence remains the same. That is the, this is known as the palindromic sequence. That means TTA, GCAC, TTA, GCAC. Because this is the palindromic sequence. DNA methylation at the CG sites is the most common method of gene inhibition in the genomic imprinting. In mammals, 70-80% of the CpG cytosines are methylated. CpG island usually has G plus C content greater than 50%. Majority of gene promoters have high CG content. In non-hematopoietic cells, DNA methylation is done to inhibit the transcription of the globin chain genes. In hematopoietic cells, genes are hypomethylated. The diploid human genome consists of 23 pairs of chromosomes. Right? This is a very common thing. It is basically composed of 20 to 25,000 genes. Haploid set of chromosomes is estimated to have 3.2 into 10 raised to 9 base pairs. Genes consisting of DNA base pairs are located on the chromosomes. A gene is a sequence of base pairs that produces a functional product including the RNA molecule and subsequently a peptide. The diploid genome consists of two alleles of each gene, as you can see over here. An allele is actually positioned on a locus. Now, what is locus? Locus is actually a specific location of a gene or DNA sequence on a chromosome. Chromosome 1 to 22, chromosome 1 to 22 are called as the autosome, and the 23rd pair is the sex chromosome, that is X and Y. So today up till here, we'll discuss about the further important notes in our next video. Thank you so much.